Hello, Ketawan Talks. Name is Doreen. I am currently studying civil engineering at Unitech, and I am the student representative for the Solomon Islands community here in Auckland.
Hello, all Keta. Me name is Wendy Andrews Mamata. I'm from Rendell Province and Wagina Choiseul Province, Los Solomon Islands, and me happy to most for come today.
We want to be able to celebrate our language with everyone else and just share about ourselves, our country, and our culture. So in the Solomon Islands, we are not just one country, like one. Our country has 9 provinces, and every province has their own languages, very, very different dialects. And so as a country, we communicate through Pidgin English. It's the one language that brings us together and, you know, helps us to transfer information and all that stuff.
So as Doreen have mentioned, we have like 9 provinces, and Rendell and Bellona is one of the provinces, and we are mainly Polynesian people. So we have Polynesian culture, like similar to other Polynesians, and different language and cultural practices as well. So that's my Polynesian side, and I'm also part like Micronesian side, which is Wagina. So mainly we're like close, related to like Kiribati people. So we have the same culture and similar traditions as well. So in terms of the differences for other provinces, they're like mainly Melanesian provinces, and we share like completely like different culture and different cultural practices and even different languages as well.
So I'm from Malaita province. In the Malaita province, for example, when women get married, we kind of send them off in a very big celebration, and this includes like dowry payments, bride price, yeah, that's what we call it. Our brides, our future husbands kind of, you know, initiate all these bride prices to our family, and then that kind of sends us off as we move on to our next part in our lives.
So like for most Melanesian cultures, they have like bride price and stuff like that, and we don't have that. And but we do have like cultural tattoos, and even the cultural dance is different as well, and as well as cultural like attires and stuff. Yeah. So for the male, mainly they have tapa. They use tapa, and they have a spear, I think. I don't know what the traditional name for that one. Okay, so when I first came to New Zealand, I think it was 2019, we had like a cultural like event for like all the scholarship students. And then we had to like share our cultural like attire and cultural food. And I remember I represent like my province, Rendell province. So I wore like cultural attire with traditional tattoos. Like, and then I wore the best female cultural like attire, and then many people like ask me about like, oh, like ask about my culture, and I had to like explain to them, and it's so nice just to share like my culture with like other people.
For people to be more aware of our country and our culture and our language, or just simply share with your one talks, your family and your friends. You know, our Solomon Islands music is pretty popular, so, you know, go check out our music, and just, you know, joining us in learning more and more about our culture and our country.
I think this is the first time we have, like, a Solomon language week, and I wish there would be, like, more, like, similar programs to this, so that we could, like, participate and showcase and share our culture to like other people as well, because not many people like know where Solomon Island is and know like about our culture. So yeah.